like a rabbit habit, and nobody does it like me. I love the rabbits, and I know the rabbits love me. I love the rabbits, and I know the rabbits, yeah, I know the rabbits love me.
Chuck. Yeah, well, Chuck is retired. Yeah, Chuck lives on a chicken farm and he felt like he had to spend more time with his roosters and his hens. Anyway, over here we have Chuck's cousin on keyboards, Rico! And on this side, on guitar, is my buddy Bob. Yeah. And we are here to bring you the Residents Shadowland, part 3 of the Randy, Chuck, and Bob trilogy. Okay, all right, so all of you out there that have been paying attention, you already know that in 2010, we did part 1. Talking Light, and it was all about ghosts and death, spooky stuff. Then, a couple of years later, we did The Wonder of Weird, part 2, and it was about sex and love. Now, it's Shadowland, and Shadowland is about birth, rebirth, reincarnation, and near-death experiences. Okay, all right, so, what have you got? What have you got? First, you had death, then sex, now birth. Ha! Life in reverse. What a concept. Okay, so get ready. Here is Shadowland, part 3 of the Randy, Chuck, and Bob trilogy. Thank you.
sometimes. Occasionally, every now and then, I love
Seattle man!
He leaves too much fat on these T-bones. He does it every time, that asshole. And I know he's gonna leave without cleaning up again. He does it every time, you know. He knows how, dude.
Oh my god.
This knife is dull. And I know he just sharpened it yesterday. I bet he's been using it. Yeah, he knows it's my favorite knife. You know, it's not supposed to be this way, you know. You know, everyone says that if you come back, it's gotta be better than it was before. No, no, it's no different. And what about the blue light? Huh? There's supposed to be a beautiful blue light. But all I saw was eels, squirming around everywhere. And life. Life doesn't have any more meaning. No. Only Buddy, it should have been him, and not me. And he should have stayed there with the eels. And now, all I can think of are his hands. Somehow, they're graceful, and they're strong, and they're sensitive. As he slices a section of rock roast and splits up the hind section of a lamb. Then, I think about how those same hands must caress the face of his wife and tie the shoelaces of his kids. And I can't stop. Can't stop.
Blaze piano, no one here. While people stood and stared.
about one single thing. He collected magazines called Women in the Ring. He kept them all in plastic bags, and everybody said that Benny talked to them at night before he went to bed.
The diversity of desire is endless, but the beauty of it, the exquisite beauty, is the world I create. It's a perfect thing, that world. A magic place, a special place,
a just the two of us place. Sometimes I think it could last forever, but it never does. No matter what they say in the beginning, no matter how much they love their boyfriends or wives or kids or whatever, they always want more. More than I can give. More than they should have. And then it's over. It's over.
Okay.
because she was bothered while feeding her daughter. Because she was bothered, we buried my father.
Is here bringing roses. seem so ridiculous. I was senior vice president in charge of marketing with Worldwide Tobacco Services. What value could absurdity hold for me? But until one day, not too long ago, I was lying in my bathtub, just relaxing, and boom, it hit me like a ton of tar. I was a garbage man, a trash collector in a previous life. And it was a good life, a nice life, a life of value, substance. I know, it seems funny, a highly successful businessman bringing home six figures, bragging about being a garbage man. But it's true, lying there in my bathtub, it was so clear. I could see myself proudly driving a brand new Marion Sidepacker, easily the late 30s most advanced refuse collecting vehicle. In a time when most municipalities were still collecting trash in a dump truck, the Marion was a highly sophisticated front loader with a mechanical compressor driven by rotating screws that tap directly into the vehicle drivetrain. That Marion is a mighty machine. And people loved me. You know, a trash collector is a genuine asset to the community, a man who provides a service of actual value. But it's all changed now. I'm retired. My wife died a year ago. Everyone says it was lung cancer, but that's not true. She had COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. I miss her.
sounding name was weightlifting Lulu, but I'm not to blame for putting the gun in your granddaddy's hand as he was implanting your face in the sand. That you left behind has given me breakfast and rendered me blind. I still want you, baby, and I miss you so much. I hated your body, but I needed your touch.
Here I come. light from far above. Too far. It kept getting closer, but it was always too far away. Till everything went black. And I died. Or something. But I came back. A week later. And I couldn't remember anything except for reaching for the light. Or the surface or something. You see, I'm a diver. I'm a free diver. Or at least I used to be. I don't know what I am anymore. You see, in the past, I wanted, I needed to be somebody, to do something, and freediving was that thing. I wanted to go deeper than anyone else, with nothing but my muscles and lungs and nerves. But I went too deep, too long, too low. But I came back. But it wasn't right. The world is not the same. Everyone is so weird. Sure, they're familiar, but they're not right. They all look at me so strangely. Their words are like lines from a bad movie. It's as if the world that I came back to isn't flat anymore. It's all pointed with weird angles, and there's nothing, and it's covered in slime and grease and mud, and I can't hold on to anything, so I'm just slipping. Slipping, slipping. And soon I'll fall off.
Thank you.
5 inches to death the sun was blind, and then she said that this could not be overcome. Dad did not believe her, so she ran away instead of feeding little animals more meaningless than dead. Second wife fell in the afternoon. She slipped into hysteria and talked about the moon. Well, this was only temporary, so the doctor said. So I watched the football game and she went off to bed.
Like most days, that Thursday was fairly uneventful. But I have to say, the thought was strong in me that morning. The thought, the unthinkable thought. It's like you just wash a frying pan and the cat walks by. And you like the cat, but you get this thought that just seizes your mind and asks, what would it be like to raise that frying pan over your head and swing it with all your might, and whack! That pan crushes that fucking cat's head like a sledgehammer crushing a cantaloupe. course, you don't do it. But there is something perversely delicious about that thought. And if you're a train operator and it's your job to drive the locomotive, the unthinkable thought is another train coming straight at you, head on. And your mind teases you with this thought, why not just fire that baby up faster and faster until the moment of impact, that holy mother of God, wham! Of slamming that sucker into the other train is all you can think about. It's intoxicating. It's seductive. Of course, it never happens. Until that day. That Thursday. And as soon as they told me, I knew I had to do it. Oh, yeah. I told myself it was too late to stop. But as I opened the throttle, and all I could feel was the absolute thrill of going faster and faster down the track. Somebody switched the other train onto a side track. I knew I couldn't be an engineer, even if they didn't fire me. Maybe I'll be an air traffic controller.
Thank you.
special ones that saw so deep inside the sickly, sorrowful, and lonely. I was down beneath the bottom when my vacant staring caught them, proudly promenading like they owned the street and all that stinking masses, free fumes and giving gases through the acrid and exhausted air. The cleansing upper atmosphere. Laughing, loving, and without a doubt, they simply strode about the streets that other creatures left alone. I ran across myself compulsive with a feeling of a pulsing drum that pounded down upon my bones. A tingling in my tangled brain was screaming that this was insane, but it also told me touch it too. Yeah. slightly out of focus spin around us till we finally realize that everything that gives us pleasure also gives us pain to measure by. And in order to survive, and the need to know we are alive. open only afternoon began. The open and the broken have begun to end again. They freeze a shape about the nape of nectar and of me. They leave a sleep, they weave a grief, for morning's never free.
Birthday, I was 44.